Please welcome co-CEOs of Notpla and the winners of the 2022 Earthshot Prize, Rodrigo García González and Pierre Paslier.
So thank you so much for having us. We are the co-founders of Notpla. We're based in London. It's nice to see a few other fellow Londoners like our mayor. And we are here because we actually use a lot of this plastic, especially single-use plastic. It's everywhere. It's so commonplace. And actually, unfortunately, too often, it ends up in our oceans. And the problem is that this material is indestructible. It was invented by humans for having really good properties, but it just stays there for hundreds of years, breaking down into microplastics. And by 2050, we're going to have more plastic than fish in our oceans. So I'm Pierre. I started my career in plastics. I was working as a packaging engineer, making tens of millions of those types of single-use plastic items. And unfortunately, knowing that these were ending up nowhere, I realized that I was not being part of the solution.
And I'm Rodrigo, originally from Spain. I started my career as an architect, and I was quite fascinated with waste. And I tried to use this waste to make buildings initially. I didn't succeed. I used it as well to try to make toys. But we decided when we met in London to try to tackle this problem from the roots, like try to think how nature does this. And if you think on a coconut, how a coconut transports water is amazing, right? It's not only water, it's coconut water, it's delicious. It doesn't generate waste, and the most beautiful part of it is that if you throw it away, the coconut, a new coconut tree will grow. Imagine if you could do that with a plastic bottle. If you throw a plastic bottle, and a plastic bottle tree will grow. We didn't want the Earthshot because of that, but maybe, you know. But we created this. We call it O, because it was the name that people give it when they see it for the first time. They make that sound, like, ooh. And basically, it's a membrane made out of seaweed that can contain water or any type of liquids. Pierre holds oranges, and right?
It's literally edible, so it's packaging you can eat. Cheers.
It's a membrane because nature uses membranes to contain any type of liquids. It's the most efficient way. And it's not a technology that we invented. It's a technology that had been there for many years in the 1930s to make things like fake caviar. And we just use it to make packaging. We scale it up, and it's made out of seaweed.
And we discovered along this journey how amazing seaweed is. First of all, seaweed grows without requiring any fresh water, any fertilizers. So compared to agriculture, humans can't really mess around with this system. It just grows on its own. And incredibly, when it grows, it actually kind of revives the oceans. It's really great for bringing fish. It can be farmed with aquaculture very easily, providing livelihood for people on the coastline. And importantly, it's so abundant. Some of the seaweed that we use grow up to 1 meter per day. So it's the fastest growing organism on this planet. And what's amazing is that seaweed has been around for about 1 billion years. So nature really knows what to do at end of life. So it means that if it ends up in nature, and inevitably a lot of our waste does, it never creates a long-lasting waste. So it really never creates the chance for plastic to create all of these problems. Unfortunately, plastic and bioplastics really create those kind of forever waste.
How we started in a student hall in London. We were buying products and inviting friends for dinner. We still have this tradition around. We were able to get some fundraising through 900 people who put from 10 pounds to a few thousands to start to build machinery. And with this machinery, we were able to start to make this product at a scale and to start to use it in different type of situations. It works quite well for short-term consumption and small volumes. So we have used it in places like the London Marathon, where we replaced it, a full water station for 46,000 runners. With edible packaging, and it was really impactful to see the station before and after in comparison with any plastic station. We are commercializing now this product with big companies to try to make energy gels as well. We have cocktails, it's a fun way as well of, of drinking. Sauces as well is a product that is really hard to recycle, the small sachets. We believe that there's a big impact there as well. But we always try to think, if this was a fruit, for example, in case of olive oil, it will be quite helpful if you can kind of use it as a pipette. Or if toothpaste was a fruit, it would be great if it's a little blueberry, so you can take a few of them for your weekend. So we always try to think not as how packaging nowadays is packaged things as plastic, but as if nature will package some type of content, how they will do it.
And we realized along the way that there were so many places where there is hidden plastic. Typically for food on the go, you might see this container that it looks like it's made from cardboard, but it's never just cardboard. Cardboard doesn't hold greasy, moist food, so you need a thin layer of plastic on the inside. So we realized that we could use the seaweed to make that coating so that the whole product is natural, biodegradable, recyclable, without needing this thin layer of plastic. Now, thanks to also the support from the Earthshot Prize, we've really scaled up. We are available in 9 countries in Europe, and we're starting to kind of like have millions of those kind of like products that are replacing plastic every day. And it's kind of amazing because we've managed to work with partners to retrofit the industry of plastic to use seaweed instead so that we don't have to build new factories. We can just use the existing factories that transform like solvents and kind of like plastic materials and just feed our material, which means that we can really quickly scale up in lots of different places. And these boxes are now being used in stadiums and in festivals, in all sorts of events where there's a very quick consumption of this material, a high chance that this doesn't really have a great kind of like end of life. And the amazing thing is that whichever end of life, it never creates a long-lasting waste because nature is very used to dealing with these materials for millions of years. So. So since winning the Earthshot Prize, it's been amazing to see more and more of those like event organizers, stadiums that are kind of like keen to work with us. We've had a little bit of help on the business development side. So thank you very much. But it's really amazing to see that we can make those moments of consumption part of like the narrative about how we switch away from plastic and bring people on the journey.
Now we are quite excited to expand our category of products. We are trying to retrofit existing packaging machinery with seaweed, with our materials for different applications, especially for these small volumes that doesn't have any type of chances of being recycled. And sometimes we have a twist. So for example, in this case, the package has salt, so you don't need to put salt on your, mm-hmm. your pasta, or in this case, it's coffee with sugar on the membrane. So if you want your coffee with sugar, you solubilize it. If you want it without sugar, you take it out. We are looking as well into how to tackle the problem of PBOH. It's the film that is used at the moment in detergent tablets. It comes from petroleum, and when it dissolves, it's a bit of a question mark in what to dissolve to. But we are always trying to see if we can add some value to these films and in what type of occasions it will make sense. Sometimes we can make it that solubilized, sometimes that doesn't, depending on the application.
And we use the transparent part of the seaweed, so you might be wondering what's happening with the rest. Well, we found a way to be more circular by actually turning this into a paper so that we can actually use the entirety of the seaweed and create packaging with it. So that's some of the other innovations that we're working on. We've also been developing recently like a rigid material which could develop things like cutlery so that we can actually expand the possibilities with seaweed material. And it's only the beginning, we're scratching the surface. Last year, we replaced about 2.5 million single-use plastic. This year, we are like on course to like double that. And thanks to the Earthshot Prize, there's a lot of opportunities coming up. We're a big team of 70 people across chemistry, engineering, design, biz dev. So it's really a team effort. And we're looking for investors and partners to really kind of like fund the next phase so that we can bring this to the US, for example. So thank you very much. We're really excited to be part of this journey with you.